getting on the horse?
I don't want to pull the horse over.
No, I don't think you will. You're on your own.
8 daters, 1 host, on a surprisingly satisfying search for love. This is Match Me If You Can.
I'm Lawrence B. Hamilton, and welcome to Match Me If You Can. We're on a mission to find love in the most surprising places by bringing together your favorite celebs of the reality world for the most epic crossover dating event of all time. Is that an exaggeration? Maybe, but also, maybe not.
Mitchell, you guys probably know me for kicking boys' butts in competitions, but today I'm trying to find love.
Hi, Ashley. How are you feeling?
I'm nervous. You know, I usually am competing against boys, not dating the boys.
Tell me about your past relationships.
The past 2 years, I really have been single, so I'm ready to kind of settle down.
You know, I think that this will be a great opportunity for you to meet someone, hopefully make a connection.
Honestly, I haven't been doing good at matching myself, so I think they're gonna definitely get the job done today.
We're taking dating apps to the next level. We have a cutting edge technology. We've analyzed everything that you had to say about your dating history, your preferences, what you're looking for. We've taken everything that you said into account to help you find love, and it's called the Pepsi Mango Matchmaker.
I'm excited.
Check it out.
Okay.
I'm Eric, last name Bigger, and I had my share of love and heartbreak on TV, and this time around, I just hope it's a pleasant surprise.
Well, hello, Eric. You look great. How are you feeling?
I feel amazing.
Good. We have analyzed your dating history, and we have found your match.
All right, I can dig it. I'm having faith in the universe that the match is gonna be perfectly made, and I can have a phenomenal day. Oh!
Hi.
Hey!
The guy that's coming up the hill right now is gorgeous. He's tall, beautiful skin, great smile, like, definitely my type, so I'm pretty excited right now.
What's your name?
Ashley.
Eric, nice to meet you.
Hi, nice
to meet
you. Okay.
There we go. Ashley, she has a great smile and nice eyes. She seems cool. I have a question.
Okay, what?
What sign are you?
Leo.
Ooh, the fire!
Believe me, I'm definitely the fire. I am a Southern girl, so I always try to be polite, no matter what.
Oh!
I think it's gonna be our date.
Just like these two are a surprisingly satisfying combination, our date will be two. So let's giddy up and get started.
Mine has just a photo of two people like eating a fancy gourmet meal, it looks like. What does yours say?
Mine's is a picture of two people riding horses.
Four horseback ride? The matchmaker said it's a 4-horseback ride. I have no idea what's about to happen. I'm just super excited.
We're going on a horseback ride. It's a surprising combination. Horseback riding, 4-course meal.
No.
You gotta, there you go.
Okay, that was much harder than I thought it was gonna be, but I did it.
Now, I'm afraid because getting on the horse is a challenge. What's up, buddy? Oh, these pants.
Okay, let me get my foot in here.
Oh, man. Can I hold on up here? It's like riding a bike for the first time, and you don't have training wheels. Oh, man. Can I hold on up here?
I don't want to pull the horse over.
No, I don't think you will.
Just gotta get on the saddle.
You're on your own. There.
Jeez.
Ride it.
Ashley, come on, horseback riding.
I'm excited to be here. I've never done a dating show, so.
Yeah, I'm all about the dates.
You're all about the dates,
yeah,
huh? You're a professional dater.
Professional dater. Dating has been fun, it's been casual, nothing too serious. So that's why I'm here. Because potentially there might be a match for me. So we're gonna have a good time. Oh, we have a meal.
Oh, hello, sir.
Hello.
Oh, a little amuse-bouche.
Really? Yeah. Got it?
Eric's asking a lot of, like, questions, really wanting to get to know me. A fancy waiter comes out of nowhere with a silver platter, a bow tie. I mean, this is five-star dining on the back of a horse. So the last 2 years I've been single, and I feel like I've just been trying to, like, focus on myself and figure out, like, really what I want, you know?
I'm thinking you're tough and strong on the outside, as well the inside, but you're probably a little softer on the inside.
I am, for sure.
He's back. What we have? Oh, mangoes. Those are my favorite, by the way.
So what do you cook?
I cook casseroles, homemade potato soup. That's good with the cheese and bacon in it. It's hard for me to open up on a first date, but Eric is really making me feel comfortable, so I'm having a good time. Oh my gosh, this looks so beautiful.
I'm gonna help you get off.
Yeah, please help me get off. Help me. I'm afraid my heels will get stuck.
Yeah, take your time.
Okay, let's see.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Good job.
What an adventure.
We made it to the top.
Look how cute this is. I love it.
We had three courses already. We're coming up the hill, and we just see this beautiful view of this picnic. Nothing but, like, fruit, mangoes, beverages.
Whoa.
What was that? Oh, that's our phone.
Yeah, where is that?
All right, so I have a question.
Yes.
The fans want to know, what is your type? Oh. And I want to know, too.
Of course, insightful. Someone with substance. Attractive, fun. Someone authentic. Someone who can bring the truth, and be themselves, and have fun, and just enjoy each other. Okay, Ashley, I have a question.
Okay.
The fans want to know, does money buy happiness?
Have you ever seen someone cry on the back of a jet ski?
No.
No, I'm kidding. I don't think money buys happiness, but I think it definitely helps.
Okay.
I don't think it really helps with the relationship, but, you know, once you get married and if you're struggling financially, then there's gonna be fights. They say most couples, that's what they fight about, is finances.
So you will never be in a broke relationship is what you're saying.
No, honey, I'll never be broke.
There's the Mazel tov, cheers to that. Can we, like, try this out? I've never, what do you call this again?
It's fondue, chocolate fondue. You good?
Oh, it's great.
It is a perfect day, honestly.
It is a perfect day. You know, we're sitting there, we're having a good conversation. I would like a kiss. Have you ever had a kiss under the sun?
I'm definitely nervous at first when Eric comes to kiss me, but once he starts, I definitely loosen up a little bit because Eric is a really good kisser.
Ooh. That's it. I think on a scale of 1 to 10, I say about a 9.5.
I prefer my meals on tables, not in stables, but to each his own. Now it's time to see if our daters will say yay or nay to each other. That was a horse pun. I just want everyone to be aware of that.
Of course, I'm a little nervous right now because I hope he swipes up on me, but all I can do is hope for the best. If he doesn't swipe up, I'll kill him because he just kissed me. I'm just kidding.
Smash.
Yeah. Oh. That's it for this episode. Be sure to tune in next time to see a new couple try their chance at love.
The Pepsi Mango Matchmaker isn't done with our daters just yet.
I actually am going to shoot you.
More twists, turns, and chances at love await on Match Me If You Can.